Good morning, children. Today we are going to continue with our chapter Plants Around Us. Now, in a previous class, we came to know the needs of plants. Now, what are the needs of plants? Soil with nutrients, then water, air, and sunlight. These four things are very important for plant to grow properly. Now in today's class, we are going to study about types of plants. Let's see types of plants. There are many different types of plants. Big and tall plants are called trees. They are of different sizes. Now children, when the plants become big or tall, what we call them? Trees. Okay, again I am telling you, when plants are big and tall, we call them trees, and they can be of different sizes. Now it can be little bit tall, it can be very tall, it can be little bit big, it can be very big. So there can be different sizes in trees. Now we will see some examples of trees. Now you can see this. What is this? This is banyan tree. In a previous class we have learned that banyan tree is one of the biggest tree in the world. So this is also one of the example for trees. Now let's see more example for trees. Can you see this? This is apple tree, one of the example for tree. Now can you see how big it is? This is big. Second example is coconut tree, and this is very tall tree. Okay, so big tree, tall tree. Then gulmohar tree. Now gulmohar tree is big as well as tall. So this is also one example of tree. And banyan tree, as you know, banyan tree is one of the biggest tree in the world. So these are the few examples of trees. Now a second category in types of plants will be shrubs. Some plants are smaller than trees. They are called shrubs. Shrubs have woody stems. Now children, the plant which are smaller than tree, and if they are having woody stems, we call them shrubs. What we call them? Shrubs. Now plants smaller than tree with the woody stems are shrubs. Again I am repeating, plants smaller than trees with a woody stem are called shrubs. Now some of the example for shrubs we can see here. Now our first picture shows is rose plant. Now if you will observe rose plant, the stem of the rose plant is very woody and they are smaller than trees. Now second is hibiscus. Same way like a rose plant, hibiscus stems are also woody and they are smaller than trees. Then sunflower plant. Sunflower plant stems is also woody and it is also smaller than trees. And a fourth example is marigold. Marigold, you can say. Some says marigold, some says marigold. Now this plant stems are also woody and they are smaller than trees. So our second category is shrubs. First category is tree, second category is shrubs. Now in tree, the big and tall plants are trees. In shrubs, the plants which are smaller than tree with a woody stem are called shrubs. Now we will see herbs. Herbs are small plants which have weak stems. Now children, these herbs plants are very small, and the stems of these plants are very weak. they can get plugged very easily. Now, can you see some example here? Our first example is spinach. Now, spinach stems are very weak and we can plug them very easy. That's why it comes under the category of herbs. Then, our second example is mint. Mint stems are also very weak and get plugged very easily. That's why this plant also comes under the category of herbs. And our third example is coriander. Now, coriander, we put in every food coriander leaves, right? Every salty foods, we put coriander leaves. And the stem of the coriander leaf, if there is coriander leaves at your home, you can observe it that the stems of this plant is very weak and you can plug them very easily. Then our fourth example is grass. Grass stems are also weak. They also get plugged very easily. So we have studied three types of plants. Now our fourth type plants is climbers. What it is? Climbers. Now some plant cannot stand up like trees. They need help to stand straight. These plants are called climbers. Now children, some of the plants are very weak to stand straight. They cannot stand straight without a support. We need to put some support like a stake or anything that support that plant to stand straight. And how they stand straight? When we give them support, when we give support to these plants, what they do? They climb that support, and with the help of that support, they stand straight. And when they climb that supporter, that's why we call this plant climbers. Okay, are you getting it? When these plants get the support of something, they climb that support, and that's why we call them climbers. Now, few examples for climbers we will see here. Now, can you see? As you see, there is a support of a stick, right? Can you see this stick? We are giving support of stick to this plant. Now, do you know which plant is this? This is grapevine. Now, what grape is doing? Grape is climbing this stick, and with the help of stick, it is standing straight. Okay? Now, our second example is bean plant. What it is? Bean plant. Now, even bean plants need support to stand straight. As soon we are going to put support near this plant, what it will do? It will start climbing that support and it can stand straight. Okay? So, bean plant is also one of the example for climbers. Now, pea plant. Same way, when we give support to pea plant, even pea plants climb that support and stand straight. That's why these plants are called climbers, because they climb the support to stand straight. Now, our fifth and last category for the types of plant will be creepers. What it will be? Creepers. Now, what do creepers do? Do you know what creeper plants do? They crawl on the ground. They grow along the ground. They do not, if we put the support also, they will not climb that support. Okay? And they cannot stand straight. They just grow along the ground. They crawl. Do you know how baby crawls on the ground? Same way these plants crawl on the ground. And that's why, because of this habit, of their crawling habit, we call them creepers. They creep. Now, few examples for creepers are here. Watermelon and pumpkin. These both plant creeps, or you can say crawl on the ground. They don't take support. They don't stand straight, or neither they take support to climb They don't need any help to climb, because they will not climb only. Okay, they just crawl on the ground. Most plants have flowers. Flowers are of different shapes, sizes, colors. Some flowers smell nice. Now, children, most of the plants have flowers, and flowers can be of different color, different shape, different sizes. Some can be big, some can be small, some can be red, yellow, pink, blue, any color can be there. Flowers can be of any color, right? And some flowers are small, some flowers are big, then some smells good and some smells bad. Some of the flowers smells nice, but and a few examples of flowers we can see: a lily, a sunflower, a lotus, a daisy. So these are the examples for flowers. Now children, we will stop here today, and I want you to go through the rest of the chapter. Now there are 5 types of plants. First is tree, second is shrubs, third is herbs, then fourth is children, come on, tell me, climbers, and fifth is creepers. You have to go through the chapter thoroughly, and in our next class we will know about the use of plants or how plants are useful to us. Okay children, take care, bye bye.